Another day. We got three walls on. The front wall of this building is pretty complicated with the amount of framed openings, but we only have our telehandler for the rest of till a certain time today. So we wanted to get some roof up. That way we can stage roofing and everything. So that's what we're doing. I've made my layout marks here off center line. You can see this black mark. And those are on 3 foot centers going down the entire length of purlin. I have Dom and Bear over there doing the same thing on the eave, except on the eave they're laying down a mastic tape. And the closure has a sticky backing on it as well. And those guys are making sure they don't stretch those. They're holding them exactly on 1 foot centers. And closure on top of it. So we got a string line on the outside so that we know where we're holding our panel. This first panel that we put up is pretty critical. We want to make sure that it's square and it's right on steel line. And it doesn't have any twists or anything in it, because if it does, we're going to have to take that out as we move along. This building has lap panels, so we have a 25 foot sheet here, or 24 and 5 inches or whatever. And then the top sheet's a little bit shorter, about 2 feet. So a little over 40 feet or 45 feet in total run per slope, and 45 on the other side. We have our sheets pre-drilled. Hopefully I didn't mess that up. And we're ready to throw a panel. On the back side of the building, we have a lift. This is where Dom and Bear were working, putting up mastic tape. But they're going to come up there and help me line this out. Say cheese, Justin.
Cheese.
And yeah, these guys are going to want to slide that. You want to slide it up?
Yep. Oh, hold on.
We're gonna let them get theirs on. They'll check their measurement and the overhang on the end. I'm gonna grab one screw, check my mod. Right into the third one. And then we can check our line. Looks pretty good. Another thing, when you're, these are gonna rust up, but you wanna be real careful, especially on painted sheets, with all these shavings from the pre-drilling. Can really jack things up. I'm still gonna be real careful sliding around on the roof, because I'll get these shavings embedded in my pants. So I'm trying to avoid sliding as much as possible. Then I'll walk up, because it is kind of cold where the mastic's been in the shade. So it's not gonna want to stick real well. When you pull this paper, it might stick to the paper and pull that mastic up, and that sucks. Like they got to stretch it down there, and I'm definitely gonna have to stretch here. So I'm gonna show you guys a trick. So I know these panels need to modulate a little bit. You don't want to step on high ribs usually, but here put just a little bit of pressure. See where we wound up. I'm gonna have to start stretching. All right, so that's the way we do the roof. We're gonna keep on keeping on. I'm gonna let Justin get down so I can bring Garrett up here. And we're gonna stay up on top until it's done. So, rock and roll.